Okay. Kita dalam scary little things lagi. Ada usual suspects.
Macam biasa.
Ada Hakim dengan ada Ed.
Who wants to go first?
I was thinking macam apa benda petty dalam bahasa Melayu. Not to say I'm for you, eh. But yeah, I was like trying my best to.
Nah, tu dah nak buat apa is petty?
Remeh. Oh my god.
Sorry, lupa.
Tadi lah kita.
So for me, whereby that during that time I was in college, and whereby that, you tahu lah, college we have to go to classes. Kalau tak ada classes, and you're tired and everything. But my ex girlfriend always said that you don't talk to me so much.
You don't talk a lot, anyways.
No, I mean like through texts or calls or whatever. Because the thing is, you tengah study, so don't tell me that every single I'm in class, I have to keep on testing you. So yeah, I don't know what you're doing. So you want me to tell you when I'm about to go in class? When I'm about to go outside of class, and once I'm outside of class, I have to keep on texting you.
So dia nak you constantly text walaupun you busy pun macam kena.
Yes.
Dia maksudnya dekat sini dia nak kena tahu apa yang kau buat lah.
Tak, it's just bukan tahu apa aku tengah buat. It's just that she wants me to always talk with her.
Entertain.
Asal dia loner ke macam mana?
Weh, Amber Heard weh.
More to like layan dia punya.
Kau kena shenanigans
lah. Shenanigans and all that lah, because it's not that they're lonely, couple. She has friends. Mm-hmm. She has friends. Mm-hmm. But it's just like,
she's not a loser lah.
She's not a loser lah. But it's like, you want attention from me all the time. Semua benda. So macam, after class, you must tunggu dalam bus ke apa, nak balik rumah ke, on the way rumah. Then after that, need to take her still, semua benda. Then, on call with her once I dah mandi, makan, semua benda. Macam like, constant attention on her sampai tidur. So
basically memang selain pada college kau kena 100% dengan dia.
So macam kalau aku tak ada kelas ke apa ke Saturday-Sunday, macam dia akan nak I want to come pick you up, let's go out semua. So macam I need to do assignments, I need to study. But still, but for her macam like I have my friends in college also, like that I need to hang out with them also. If you want you can hang out with my friends. Tapi dia macam, no, I just want to be us.
Berat tu.
Tapi dia boleh masuk dengan kawan-kawan you tak? Ataupun
she would try.
Sekali-sekala boleh lah. But every time, Masya Allah.
The most annoying thing. It's not like us tau. Macam, I know that you are busy. You need to do this. So I just let it be. But it's just sometimes like for 2-3 hours at least like keep it update like I tengah buat ni, orang tengah sibuk ni. Macam, I'm fine with that. But the whole time, like, constantly texting.
Dia macam tak boleh respect you punya time for you.
I don't have a me time. It's always like, it's a us time.
Okay. Well, maybe is it age factor?
Might be. Young, still young, you know. Macam have that kind of enthusiasm,
drive, fire, gitu.
Still honeymoon phase.
Yeah, fire.
Don't know, maybe for you lah kot, but I don't know.
Tak, benda ni berlaku kat lelaki je kan, kata kat perempuan sebenarnya. You rasa you ada tak buat macam tu?
Well, to be honest, sebab kita kena faham juga, diorang mesti ada that me time for themselves. No matter what, sebab dia.
Tapi masa sekarang, diorang tahu benda tu. Tapi diorang mesti buat. So, macam mana tu?
Itu maksudnya, then constantly like that, dia perlukan that clinginess and attention tu. Maksudnya, she herself, atau he lah in this, ni kita tak boleh nak berat any gender. Maksudnya dia memang betul ada rasa constant self insecurity.
I think boys very badly. Guys, I don't know, guys, boys, men. Ada juga yang macam tu.
I know.
Tapi jarang lah saya jumpa orang macam tu. Tapi normally banyak kat
perempuan. Ya, sebab dia perempuan memang tak boleh dipisahkan dengan rasa insecure. Yang tu memang confirm.
Ya, insecure.
Lelaki pun ada juga
rasa insecure. Ya, setelah ikut kan ada juga macam tu.
But you guys don't like to show.
Yeah, you guys have ego.
Men don't show because a lot of reasons, and I think majority of guys out there would know. It tends to do like that because, okay, we have to admit, sometimes guys can not egoistic, it's more to the have that you have to portray that you are the man.
Yeah.
The man, whereby that you cannot show emotional
tinggi. You ada self control.
Yes.
Emotional sensitivity.
A lot of other people think that as weakness.
I mean, most guys don't like to show that, but most girls want a guy. Oh, I want a sensitive guy. Tapi bila dapat sensitive guy, mampus tak terlayan. I just realized that.
Okay.
What you get what you want later, alamak menyesal.
Dia ada that kind of orang kata apa, imbalance there lah. Orang tak kerti nak imbalance. So senang cerita, there's no mutual understanding there lah sebenarnya.
So honestly speaking, you rasa macam tu tak?
Me?
Jenis yang remeh.
Kalau nak kata, I have that kind of petty, to be honest, ada a little bit. Tapi not so, to that so, kind of level lah, tidak lah.
So macam mana you overcome benda?
Nak tak nak sebenarnya, I kena ada that, I punya sendiri punya self-control. Itu bergantung pada diri I sendiri. I have that, yes. Tapi I kena tahu diri I cannot do that to other people if I don't want that person to do that to me. If I want that person to do that for me also pun, I need to respect. Diorang ada masa diorang. Diorang ada cara diorang. Diorang ada diorang
punya mentality. She knows fairness.
I have to think about how other people feel also. Respect diorang punya time also. Tapi I tak boleh nafikan, I have that kind of cleanliness.
Adakah benda tu berkaitan dengan faktor umur?
Kalau bandingkan dengan dulu dengan sekarang, to be honest, I tak ada rasa beza dia sangat. Sebab tak tahu kenapa, I rasa macam daripada dulu.
Lebih kepada experience lah.
Ya, lebih kepada experience, yes. Sebab bila you clean me 24 jam, you nak kata tak ada life, you ada life. But it won't jaminkan apa-apa. You understand? Tapi bila you tak clean me pun, also dia tak jamin apa-apa.
Yeah.
So, might as well you just have the mutual understanding, you just go from there, that's it.
So, you rasa benda ni bagus tak untuk you?
Apa, clingy?
Yes.
Being clingy? Kalau nak kata dari segi husband and wife, memang patutlah.
No.
Kalau relationship, in general wise. For me, nak kata bagus tu, seeloknya you need to have balanced time to focus on diri you sebenarnya. So, to be fully clingy while you are still in a relationship yang bukan marriage lagi, I believe that it's not that of a good idea.
Better to have that clinginess when you are married.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, if you have that before marriage and then you proceed into marriage, then after that, that's the cause of it, whereby that.
You rasa bila you clingy masih bercinta tu kan, nanti rasa tak puas. Bila you dah kahwin, nanti it will become a problem. I don't know. Itu datang from experience yang I nampak and also I sendiri pernah lalui dulu.
Okay, dah cerita.
Dah pernah lalui dulu. So, I rasa macam you need to really have that discussion lah with your spouse, with your partner about it lah. You tak boleh nak ikut serta tak pak je kan about tu. Tapi, kalau terlalu berjauhan juga pun tak boleh. Kita cakap benda kena discuss.
So, maksudnya kat sini conclusionnya kalau in relationship, better balance. So, maksudnya clingy ni still perlu bila dah married lah.
Sebenarnya clingy sebab macam mana pun you hidup berkahwin, you hidup berdua.
So, your experience?
Aku dah cakap banyak-banyak. Okay, my experience yang petty. For me, benda yang paling petty sekali adalah I was in a relationship di mana tak kisah apa yang I cakap pun jadi salah.
Itu bukan confirm kami. Sorry.
Mana tahu.
Kenapa benda macam ni tak boleh? You know, I'm asking.
You cannot have your own opinion.
Yeah, I cannot have my own opinion. Macam I tanya soalan tu, okay, contohnya the other person, dia cakap
beliau
tu lah, dia cakap santi ke apa kan. Lepas tu, I just mempersoalkan out of orang kata apa, curiosity. Memang I betul nak tahu benda tu tau. It's just a question. And then sendiri I kata, kenapa you bengap sangat? You know, things like that. Lepas tu dia cakap lah, datangkan benda macam tu you tak tahu. Things like that tau. Itu mungkin dengar macam benda yang kecil apa semua. But constantly bila you kena macam
lama-lama,
tu,
lama-lama rasa macam kau setakat petty tau. It brings down your morale. You punya self-value. You rasa macam, aku ni bodoh sangat ke?
Yeah, exactly. Macam kita ni betul-betul kuduk ke macam mana ke tak tahu kan. Should I know this? Is this something general knowledge that I should know? Macam contohnya ikan ni kenapa dia kena apa macam hidup you know with this kind of environment or anything, you know, just borak benda-benda general wise kan. Takkan benda macam tu pun you tak tahu.
Yeah, you cannot have that conversation whereby macam dia more to like apa kita berbincang.
This kind of people is more to orang yang dah know it all.
Orang punya general knowledge might not be our general knowledge.
Yes.
Kita mungkin sama IBM.
Dia ni punya general.
Tak tahu.
Dia general knowledge dia pasal kereta macam ni je. Kejap lagi dia tanya, dia cakap dengan kita, kita pun macam, huh?
Tapi dia tak memperendahkan. Dia macam informing, it's fine, yes. But bila you sebut, you kata, katakan benda macam tu, you tak tahu.
Dia maksudnya dia mempersoalkan apa yang you tak tahu.
Lepas tu dia kata lah, kalau you tak tahu, then what's the point of me telling you? Tak apa lagi pula, tak apa nasi kau gitu. So, jangan cerita dia, I rasa macam, you know what, it's okay lah, you don't want to explain it to me. It's fine lah kan, I dah tak berminat nak tahu lagi dah. Sedangkan I memang genuinely want to know. And then lagi satu yang membuatkan rasa petty kan, bila dia berbual-bual-bual-bual dia nak cakap dia tu kan, I just diam je. You dengar ke tak dengar apa yang cakap ni? Ke you tak faham langsung apa yang cakap? Aku jadi jam-jam.
Rina aku jam.
Cakap salah tak cakap salah? Kalau aku tanya salah, kalau aku nak bercakap something, tiba-tiba aku pula tiba wow dan wow ha-nya. So, that's the pettiest lah yang pernah saya lalui lah.
Wow. Okay, now Akim. I want to know.
Benda yang macam ni kena, actually saya pernah juga kena lah masa zaman college jugalah sebenarnya. Bagus, nak kerja, nak kembali mana, nak pergi mana, nak kena bagi tahu. Every time nak kena check in. Dah jadi macam, time tu zaman posko eh. So, macam dah jadi posko eh. Mesti nak kena bagi tahu kat sini, kat mana. So, macam sekarang benda tu dia nak. So, dia nak tahu aku pergi mana, aku dengan siapa. So, basically sebab...
Oh, that kind of girl.
Definitely not me lah.
That is true. Kau dengan siapa, masa after that, kalau tak cakap, I see someone else, someone tu was like, that person just came. You tak beritahu pun, like, seriously, it's not even my friend. Never tell.
Okay, so, benda tu berlaku aku, memang almost every day lah. Tapi itulah, almost every day pun dekat 2 tahun, 3 tahun dia ada dengan dia.
Sama lah
korang
ni
rendah. Macam mana kita boleh tahan dengan orang macam ni?
Sebab satu mungkin, sebab mungkin beza apa, I dengan you mungkin sebab dia depan mata. Sebab I dia jauh.
So, long distance.
Yes, long distance relationship. So, problem dekat situ lah. Tapi, as long macam, actually I tak ada persoalkan dia nak pergi mana.
Tapi dia buat, macam tu dekat kau?
No.
So, you have to do it but she doesn't have to
do it? No. Okay. Sebab dia dulu, it's just, wow. Sebab style aku, kalau sebelum boleh kau nak pergi mana, kau pergi ikut kau boleh suka. Just lagi tak nampak depan mata aku, kau selamat lah.
It's appreciative jugalah kalau dia pun boleh buat benda yang sama. Kalau dia dah minta, dia kena buat benda yang sama. Duh, you cannot be double standard about it.
Tak tahu lah, mungkin dia ingat kita kat KL player kot.
Wasap.
Kadang-kadang sampai satu peringkat jadi macam aku nak main pusat pun ganggu. Nak masuk kelas pada pagi-pagi nak kena bagi tahu. Dia bukan marah tau, dia buat kita rasa guilty tau. Pasal buat macam ni tak sayang kita ke. Okay, so ambil last kali separate. Sakit kepala.
Sakit kepala.
So tapi bila dah lepas tu gila rasa macam, eh handphone aku tak bunyi. Aku lagi, eh tak ada bunyi.
Bateri
tak lama.
Rasanya kat kita sempat-empat kat sini sebenarnya, kita memang jenis tak ada muzuk.
Ini tak susah nak pujuk sangat. Sebab satu benda, dia kalau marah, yang cakap dengan dia 24 jam. Even as a bee.
Nah, style aku kalau aku marah, aku tinggalkan aku 24 jam.
24 jam ke
24 jam?
24
jam.
Okay, satu hari lah.
Satu hari untuk aku main game, buat apa aku suka, cari cepil balik. So, lepas tu okey. So, anggap benda tu tak terjadi.
Sebab kau fikir, is it because kau takut kau sangkap something atau something yang kau akan menyesal?
Yes, itu satulah. Takut benda yang tak patut aku sebut, aku terbawa sama. Pada masa yang sama, actually bukan nak repair, actually make it worse.
I'm just asking, because the thing is I'm also the same.
Sayang, we both got better, we improve. Together, that's good enough. Better. Yeah. I salah, I pun, I betulkan, you salah, you betulkan. We just improving.
Yeah.
24 hours, so whether you don't want to say bad things or hurtful things because you're drive from emotions.
Betul.
So we need time to cool off. Whether it's better to actually say those kind of things, at least you can fix it and know what you're supposed to actually.
Itu yang cuba aku buat. So sebab ya, untuk tidak drag lagi masa lagi jauh, lebih stop sekejap. Tenang-tenang, have fun, buat benda yang tak, buat benda di luar petak. Kan? So lepas tu you okay.
But for me,
tapi tak ada discussion pun.
Because for me,
better untuk kes macam tu, better lupa tu daripada nak kena ingat balik.
How to
sakit.
But for me, it's much more better because the thing is, by that man, you need to cry. And it's better to cry with your
spouse.
Macam kami memang practice discussing lah. Memang dengar tu, discussing, not avoiding, okay?
Dia nak kata discuss. Discuss, bukan tak ada discuss. Cuma, tapi itulah, for me better I need 24 hours to
it's up to you.
Tenang, mungkin that one, itu mungkin style aku lah. Mungkin tak semua orang suka lah kan.
Actually, I ada style macam jenis yang kalau dia senyap, kan dia senyap je kan. I ni macam tak boleh tau, I just want it.
That one I tahu you, yes. You mesti akan tanya, you okay tak?
I can resolve cepat tau, I nak benda tu
susah. Ya,
back then, yes. Bila dah 4 tahun, masa 4 tahun kami ni kan. Okay, dia buat macam tu.
Tak tahu lah, kan?
Ada isinya.
And I cannot
you can stand.
And dia tak tahan.
Normal lah.
Dan dia tak tahan bila senyap. Sebab before that, I was totally different. Tapi sekarang ni, bila kalau dia senyap kan, kalau kita orang macam ada dekat balah tu kan. Dia senyap, dia tengok I kat sebelah tu. Senyap, buat muka batu eh, buat muka bodoh eh. Kalau tak buat muka bodoh, orang kata muka yang resting bitch face.
Resting face.
Buat kerja I tu kan. Then baru dia macam approach yang
this is actually good because for me it actually comes to her and wanting to resolve it immediately.
Mungkin elok lah benda situ lah. Tapi still I need that window.
Memang benda tu sebenarnya perlu pun. Sebab apa kata korang tak nak bercakap dalam keadaan marah. Driving by emotions.
So instead aku fikir aku melepaskan geram dekat benda yang tak perlu, lebih aku diam, paling tidak aku main game. Itu antara cara aku lah. Tapi aku tak adalah buat kerja gila nak pergi driving ke mana-mana. It's just I need my 24 hours nak settle down sekejap. Lepas tu okey dah.
So basically it depends on your spouse and you. Macam mana you nak adjust. You just have to know where to improve here and there. Because being petty is ada good and bad.
Yeah, relationships is like growing together but kan you grow together.
Okay, but now finale. Edwina,
diorang ingatkan cerita aku macam kita hangat lah. Sebenarnya aku rasa aku tak ada petty. I think I'm petty rather than the
orang cakap mungkin dia tak merasa sebab sebenarnya benda tu datang
aku yang petty dia.
From your point of view as a person yang you rasa you yang petty.
Macam I clingy. I think it comes with the age lah. Sekarang macam tak kalah pada apa aku. Asalkan kau jangan you don't cheat on me, that kind of thing lah. And you know how to take care of yourself outside. Ini tu one thing for sure. Dulu I pun pernah bombard ex-boyfriend I macam tu. Sampai ada one of it pun pernah mention kat I, oh you too clingy, I cannot stand you.
Adakah sebab kita ni lelaki sebab tak nak ambil tahu sangat ke, sebab kita tak suka, tak sayang ke, ataupun macam mana?
Insecurity.
Eh, tak apa-apa. She girls, some girls, okay, not saying
female. Yeah.
There's some girls.
Disclaimer, we are not saying all genders are the same.
It's like, okay lah, guys or girls lah. Sebab they have this feeling whereby that kalau kau tak ambil tahu, kau tak bagi tahu, kau tak sayang.
Yeah.
That's
I'm like,
one thing lah.
Unfortunately, I was like that. Yeah. I think ada a bit lagi lah like that.
Lagi aggressive kot.
Yeah, because I have a husband right now, okay? Kena aggressive sikit. So if this is like a tie, hidup mati ya. You tend to be more aggressive at times when it's needed lah. Ada clingy.
We've had heartbreaks and all. If you've invested your feelings, so you have become that kind of person.
Yeah.
So that one is understandable. But for those yang tak develop those kind of things, those petty things, but you yourself abadi, that one you need to understand it.
Kadang-kadang orang sedar ke tak benda ni macam ni?
Orang takkan sedar, because the thing is for me, even though you tell that person in their face, they won't want to admit they are at fault.
I sanggup, ngaku.
Nah.
So dia punya
Most people ha. Tapi tak semua kan. Tapi
majority lah, sorry to say.
You are rare. Being able to admit that you are petty is actually you can free yourself lah actually.
So kalau let's say kalau lelaki dapat perempuan yang clingy ni kan, so apa yang dia kena buat?
You need to talk it out. Whereby that either sides have to understand that I need a me time. I have family, I have friends, I have work or studies or whatever. You have to have that.
You have other commitments.
You have other commitments. You have to have that space because you're always together before marriage. This is what I'm talking about, before marriage. It will not feel the same once you get married because the thing is you be staying together, you sleep and wake up next to that person. Then after that, would it die down? If it won't die down, it's a good thing.
This is general in relationship. Pettiest thing lah. Nak makan mana?
Saya masalah sekarang ni kalau contohlah yang perempuan tanya ke lelaki nak makan mana.
Patutnya bagi idea, patutnya reject.
Ikutlah. Lepas tu bila dah sampai tu, okay, kita pergi sini. Dah sampai, eh tak nak ambil lain pula.
I somehow think that women thinks that men are...
We are not psychic.
I was about to say that. Psychic. I trust me lah, if women know how to pick kedai makan, apa, decide nak makan mana kan? 70% of your relationship will work out, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Boleh jadi punca gaduh lah.
Dia boleh.
Sebab nak decide nak pergi makan, tak payah cerita lah. Keluar pergi mana pun, nak pergi makan je dulu.
Dia boleh melanggar jadi
kena.
I have a very strange, apa orang kata?
Palate.
Which my husband sometimes cannot tahan. Sometimes I want to eat Korean food. He was like, huh?
Aku makan nasi padang.
Nasi campur.
Food.
Aku jenis kecelik lah, aku tak kisah aku nak makan apa-apa pun. Cuma macam dia punya selera tu macam di luar pemikiran aku tau. Macam sampai ni tengah kadang-kadang tengah serabut ke apa ke lagi. Tiba nak akan makan masakan Korea lah. Lagi kan ada belik-belik Shopee food ke apa ke, kejap lagi sushi ni macam sedap, sushi pula. Lepas tu, sorry, cendol, ada promotion cendol pula, apa nombor satu ni.
Ada one time tu kan, saya cakap dengan dia, sayang, I want to eat truffle fries. Mondor pula tu.
Dah ke Europe pula.
Aku rasa itu yang benda yang paling ridiculous aku pernah minta kat laki aku. Yang laki aku sampai sekarang tak boleh comprehend. So, I minta, you kalau tak nak bagi truffle fries, betul apa? I nak pasta truffle. Apa mondor pula. Makin mahal pula
tetap punya aku ni. Aku tak kisah nak makan macam mana pun. Cuma, tak tahu lah, dia punya selera tu, dia punya menu tu dah level-level
menu.
Aku satu buku, satu page je. Dia 10 page pun tak belum tentu settle.
My pettiness is on food lah. Which my husband now has to face almost every day.
Pening weh nak melayan. Tapi selera pelik-pelik tu. Awak eis. Asal aku jauh. Tiba.
Hari
asal aku jauh.
Hari tu, I pergi makan dengan dia, pergi mana. Tiba-tiba, I order topoki. Betul ke tak?
Topoki Korean punya tu.
Rice.
Kita tak ingat. Betul?
I sumpah
kan? Tak ingat tu.
Apa benda ni? Topoki. Puteri, ha? Apa poki?
Bunyi exhaust. Dekat time tu dekat festival. So, bising lah. Aku tengah set up phone. Lepas tu je, aku tengok sushi. Nampak macam sebab tu. Nampak macam sushi.
I beli sushi juga.
So, aku assuming dia makan sushi lah. Lepas tu cakap, sedap tak topoki? Apa nak sebut popoki?
Topoki
kan? Nak sebut pun payah. Sebab aku tak nak ingat tu, sebab aku rasa annoying gila tu. Makan benda ni. Tapi sedap. Tapi sedap masalahnya. Tapi dia letak dekat atas satu table, satu tempat. So I assuming dulu it's sushi. Cuma di
unless kalau if you guys get girls yang senang pilih makan,
guys or girls,
simpanlah. Kau simpanlah orang tu.
Yeah.
Because
if your partner
dia nak cakap macam tu tak boleh juga kadang. Sebab kalau kita tanya kan, macam contoh nak ke mana, tak kisah, makan nasi ayam pun boleh. Dan sampai nasi ayam, nasi ayam pun tak sedap lah.
Ibarat lain lah. Maksud adalah memang dia tak kisah langsung. Kalau macam cara saya dengan Amir, kita orang dah sampai tempat tu. Kita orang decide mana tempat nak pergi. Sebab sebenarnya destination tu yang paling pemeningkan bela.
Kau jangan jalan KL lagi, punya budget.
Dekat situ, bila tengok menu, okey dah, ada glue ni. Boleh lah. That's it lah.
So, what do you think? Benda ni perlu ke tak dalam relationship?
Apa? Being petty?
Yes.
Well, kalau bendanya sebenarnya kita bukan nak kata perlu tak perlu, sebenarnya benda tu tak boleh dielakkan. Yep. Benda tu tak boleh dielakkan. Benda tu mesti akan ada punya. Being, being clingy, ada rasa macam that differences yang mungkin nampak petty, contohnya macam food differences, yeah, kan? Food preferences yang different, kan? So benda tu sebenarnya tak boleh dielakkan sebab each person ada karakteristik yang berbeza, kan? Cuma yang paling penting sekali, whether that pettiness tu actually membuatkan korang boleh vibing together, korang punya differences tu ataupun tidak. Sebenarnya setiap orang kalau petty dia jenis macam ni, jenis macam ni, lepas tu korang boleh macam actually compromise, tolak ansur sama-sama, apa salahnya? This one learn this one's way, this one learn this person's way. Lepas tu, tu kata boleh memahami each other, kan?
It's just that when you're being petty but you are apa tu, improvising or compromising, it's good. But don't be petty, compromise, but you still want to be petty.
Then be petty, don't compromise, be petty sama. Itu memang kena sepak.
Jadi, saya bagi contoh je lah. Macam, I ni jenis yang tak boleh nak, apa, bukan tak boleh nak, I'm very indecisive. Contohnya macam, I rasa, oh, I want to buy this, I want to buy that. And then, bila dah sampai tempat tu, tak apalah yang kita save duit lah. Amir will get easily annoyed by it. Very, very much. Benda tu petty, tapi Amir will get very annoyed. Dude,
I get, okay, because the thing is, the reason I get annoyed is by that, okay, for example, you say that you want to eat laksa, and then we already went to do the things, and then we see laksa, I feel like, okay, I'm going to actually fulfill what she wants. Okay, that's laksa, you want laksa? Nah, I don't feel like eating laksa, tu pun saya tak payah lah.
Sebab je, tapi benda tu cuma jadi bila I'm pregnant. Okay, let's be clear that lah.
Okay.
Okay? Tapi kita cakap before I got pregnant. Hello. But okay, I have that kind of indecisiveness lah. But apa, kalau pasal makanan, tak sangat.
Makanan, no. For me, because you it's not easily fulfilled. It's just that you, when you love a certain food, you just
makan dia boleh berulang lah.
Ha, berulang. Well, she like sushi. She makan dengan sushi, she'll be happy. And I know what she wants. So, if I get for her, it's so easy.
Tak, cuma itu je lah cakap bila pregnant tu susah sikit lah. Sebab saya kadang-kadang satu masa, oh, terasa macam nak makan laksa. Sebab macam mana dia? Lepas tu bila dah sampai ke tempat laksa tu, bawa laksa, astagfirullahaladzim.
So basically, I'm constantly pregnant lah ni.
Berasa diri you petty lah sebenarnya.
How that person talk to me? Contohnya macam bila cakap orang tu elok, tapi orang tu sendiri being macam rude to me, I tu ni angin. Dan macam, yo, I'm talking to you nicely, can't you just talk to me nicely balik?
Adakah itu barang?
I?
Yes.
No, common courtesy.
It's actually, I fikirkan common courtesy. Yeah, I fikirkan that common, apa, if I'm talking to you nicely, I'm being nice to you, can't you be nice back? Don't you have any common sense there, you know, then?
Adab tadi.
So I have that kind of pettiness. Okay. Part tu, I tak boleh nak sabar sikit. So if someone tu being rude to me, I will be 10 times rude. You do that to me, kan? Kau siap, eh? Jadi macam tu. Itu pula boleh dikatakan dia punya pettiness. Sebab dia jenis cepat annoyed. Itu cakap.
Pujuk lah, pujuk.
Tak maksudnya.
Pujuk
lah. Tapi itu cakap. After years, bila dah kahwin apa semua, we improvise ourselves. We fix apa mana yang kita rasa, apa kata you bad attributes, right? Macam dia dah tak ada lagi cepat annoyed with anything. I also tahu perangai dia yang cepat annoyed itu, I will decide. I tak ada lagi dah nak indecisive ke, tak pelayan, tak pergi lah apa semua. I tak ada. I cuba untuk tidak. Sebab itu orang kata tolak ansur. Tapi at least kita orang tahu kita orang punya each other punya pettiness.
At least
tahu.
Okay. Kau rasa kau petty tak?
With family, yes.
Oh, yeah.
That one I have to be really blunt in it because I've lived with them for my whole life. So, the thing is, okay lah, I will open the story. Whereby that kalau dapat makan tadi. For example, okay, my mom, my sister said they wanted to go AC a few days back, for example. And then I totally forgot about it. Then they said they wanted to go eat. Then I asked them, why you guys want to eat anything? Okay, maybe No. KFC, no. The one fast food. Okay, fine. Chinese shop ke, Malay shop ke, apa ke, mamak ke. No, tak nak. So, then what do you guys want to eat? Anything. Then I have to think and think and think, and seriously, I was like, wait, they said they wanted to go AC before this. You guys want to go AC? Yeah. Could you have just said so? Then, okay, you want to go AC? Okay, fine. Drove them all the way to Subang. Went to AC. I told them, okay, I'm going to drop both of you off. Go get a seat and order. No, it's okay, we go together. Everyone knows in AC, you won't get parking right in front of the freaking doorstep.
Sampai tu dah dapat memang luck gila.
Ah, I kesian my mum and my sister have to walk far. And then saya cepat cepat duduk susah. So drop off. Then I said no, we go together. Okay, fine. I had to park all the way at Maybank and went to walk all the way there.
Wait,
and
in
the end,
shit lah.
Yes, thank you for understanding. Thank you.
Manakah dia ada that kind of experience? Sebab tu in general Wahzi tak suka orang yang indecisive. Orang yang tak boleh nak decide. So tu bila kadang-kadang bila mula bercinta dulu I have that indecisiveness. Saya macam fikir, oh I want to find this. Lepas tu fikir balik, oh lepas tak ada, tak apalah. Itu yang dia tak suka. Kata, can you please not be indecisive? Sebab dia dah ada that experience. So sebab tu dia cepat annoyed. I pula jadi saya tak suka orang cepat annoyed. So you know that.
But we got married to each other.
But we got married to each other.
I opposite attracts.
So apa yang you rasa, apa yang you petty?
Tak. Tak.
That's the problem tau. When he's not petty, he doesn't go into details.
I think that's the pettiness.
So yeah, aku yang jadi, aku yang macam petty.
There is pettiness.
Maybe that's the form another pettiness.
Maksudnya kat sini sebab tak aku tak berapa detail, so aku macam tu.
Mungkin ada, yeah, that's a different
bagi
form
you,
of pettiness.
Bagi you pettiness is petty, so you tak nak fikir. Yes. So in the end, aku yang jadi. You know, if your husband is too plain, he just go with the flow. He doesn't have any plan.
Aku tak boleh instead daripada aku nak kena fikir. Lebih just you make a decision. Lebih kita pergi. So in the end, aku takkan rasa bersalah kalau anda kata benda tu jadi di luar plan.
Yang plain, lebih plain tu. Buat aku jadi petty. Sayang, how about this? Why should we do this? Aku dah plan for like 5 years ahead. He's still like that. I kata, ah, tak apa, we go with the flow first.
Dah, dah lah, jelah.
Bini dah sebelah. No wonder.
Opposite attract, guys.
So, in the end, macam, no wonder I look so freaking petty. Yeah, because my husband is so relaxed. So macam I'm the one who's uptight. No wonder pergi doktor, pergi check dia tak ada blood pressure, aku dah ada nak blood pressure.
Pettiness tu ada importance dia.
Yeah,
ada importance.
Certainty.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
what is a pro and con.
Yeah. It's how you use your pettiness lah.
Cuma satu benda je aku very very particular.
Sardin kena ayam brand.
Ayam brand. Kalau aku dapat brand yang lain, aku takkan makan.
Sebab dia punya rasa lain.
Ada lagi satu benda. Oh tak, ada few things lah. Chili sauce kena live.
Okay, betul.
I kena Sunquick Ribena je. Cordial FNN dia tak pandang.
Betul.
I actually understand that.
So, yeah. Apa lah.
So maksudnya aku jenis particular sebab makan juga, jenis brand untuk makan.
Oh.
So tapi Sardin aku mesti nak ayam brand.
Okay, I think they will come to the end.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's that. Thank you very much.
Alright, thank you very much for tuning in.
Okay, korang boleh tengok ni kat dalam YouTube, dalam Scary Little Things in Marcy Broadcast. And also dalam Spotify pun ada under Scary Little Things. Korang boleh search je, memang ada podcast ni. So you guys please take care.
It's like simple tau. Tak butak bak dengan wagyu beef.